In this tutorial, we're going to create the asset browser version of the Extreme PBR libraries. Make sure you are in a new end and save Blender project. Now let's go to the end preferences. Important note: make sure you have the add-in updated to version the 1st of April 100 or higher. Otherwise, it will not be possible to create the asset browser version of the libraries. The Extreme PBR library must be installed in order to convert it. Select the Libraries tab. If the libraries are connected correctly, the corresponding buttons will be shown to convert them into the asset browser version. To create the default library, press the Default Library button. Press Yes and then OK to start creating the asset browser. During this process, the entire asset browser library will be created or updated. The speed of the process depends a lot on the speed of the hard disk. If you are using an SSD, the process will be much faster. You can stop the process by pressing the button next to the progress bar. I suggest you let it finish. With a Samsung SSD 980 Pro, the process will take about 10 minutes if you have installed all the libraries up to 8K. Alternatively, logically, it will take much less. Now, let's go to Blender's asset browser interface. In the asset list, we now have a new asset, named Extreme PBR. If not, try pressing the refresh button or restart Blender. We have now all Extreme PBR default library into asset browser. All Extreme PBR material tags are now also present in the asset, including license information. The asset is divided into size formats. And then all the categories, just like they were organized in Extreme PBR. Now with a drag and drop, you can add Extreme PBR materials directly from the asset browser to the scene. It is recommended to restart Blender to make the asterisk disappear from the names of the Extreme PBR libraries. It will be sufficient to save any project. It is not necessary to do it immediately. Thanks for watching.